Hi, I'm Richard.
I'm Margo.
And this is week four of Wednesday Night Hop's Tranky Doo series.
September 2014. So this week was really the last week of the series, so we didn't work on anything really new, except we worked on one new variation. We did the slip slop jazz square, and we worked on the idea of using your foot to stay in contact with the floor and hopping towards the side that your foot is picked up on. So if our foot's up on our left side, we're going to throw our hip to the left and drag our foot along. And then if we go to the right, we're going to do it a hop to the right. Nice. So the way that fit into the jazz square is Richard's going to turn around and face the back so you can see from the back. We're going to do a cross on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we talked about the idea of making sure that your slip slop brings you to the 3, the 5, and the 7 when you actually make those hits and land. Yeah, and a good way to practice is just to go left to right to practice working on your slip slops and make sure your foot stays in contact with the floor. Some other things that we played around with this week were what Richard and I were calling experiments or challenges for yourself, and you can make these up as you go. One that we tried was the idea of keeping your feet in contact with the floor, kind of dragging around, as opposed to picking your feet way up off the floor and really making a little bit of noise, like that. Other things that you could try are big arms, small arms. We did one that was a lot of fun. We did a mirrored version of the Tranky Doo where we did everything on the wrong foot. So instead of starting with our right side fall off the lugs, we started with our left, and we did a shuffle around to the right, and we'll leave the rest to the imagination. excuse me. And then we spent quite a little bit of time trying out some different songs. The idea being that challenging yourself to do the routine to something that you don't have musical anchors to is a really good way to practice and make sure that you know the routine by heart and it's not tied to a specific song.
And we discovered that I did not know the routine by heart.
But being able to hear in the music when the phrase starts new at the head of the song partway through, that's a good way to learn where to start fresh from the very beginning again, partway through the song. Yeah. And then the last thing that we did was we performed a little bit for each other. We got an opportunity to make sure that our head was up, that we were getting a chance to try out any funny variations that we wanted to do, and basically just have a good time. I hope you enjoyed the month, and we'll hope to see you again sometime soon.